Therefore, to the utmost of my power, I shall and will defend this doctrine and his holiness right and custom against all usurpers of the heretical or Protestant authority, and all adherents in regards that they be usurped and heretical opposing the Sacred Mother, Church of Rome. I do further promise and declare that notwithstanding I am dispensed with to assume any religion heretical for the propagating of the Mother Church's interest. I furthermore promise and declare that I will wage relentless war, secretly or openly, against all heretics, Protestants, and liberals, to extirpate and exterminate them from the face of the whole earth, and that I will hang, burn, waste, boil, and flay, and strangle and bury alive these infamous heretics, rip up the stomachs of the wombs of their women, and crush their infant heads against the walls, in order to annihilate forever their execrable race.
Father General Superior, I am honored that you have come to see me.
I am happy that you are here, my son. I have heard many good things about your experiments, that they have yielded miraculous breakthroughs, and not a moment too soon.
Father, I feel that my staff and I are right at the verge of being able to deliver the product. We just have a few glitches to work out, but this last phase just seems to have puzzles.
Yes, but they shall be solved in the due time. We have taught you many things, not the least of which is how to solve puzzles. How is your wife?
My wife? Well, thank you for asking. She's doing quite well. Thank you, Father.
Oh, now, is that all she is?
Oh, yes, Father. I assure you that she knows nothing of our work, and Father, she will not be in the way, I promise you.
Then just remember, it is from my grace alone that you are allowed to be with this woman, for it is forbidden for a priest to marry.
Yes, Father, I'm most grateful for this indulgence that you have given to me, and I will not take any of your grace for granted, Father.
Then do not forget, if our holy order should ever discover that you are taking your role too seriously, I would hate to be you.
No, Father, I assure you that it's nothing like that, Father. She's just my proxy wife, Father, and that's the whole of it. I assure you that I'm not emotionally attached with all of this.
Good. Now let us discuss your upcoming travels.
We must spread our truth to our Protestant brethren. Dus volte, God commands it.
The Jesuit priests have been infiltrating every institution, and they're ready now for a takeover. This means that at the end of time, Roman Catholicism is working in secret with the rulers of this world in an effort to control the world, to take it over.
In 1986, Pope John Paul II gathered in Assisi, Italy, the leaders of the world's major religions to pray for peace. There were snake worshippers, fire worshippers, spiritists, animists, Buddhists, Muslims, Hindus, North American witch doctors. I watched in astonishment as they walked to the microphone to pray. The Pope said they were all praying to the same God, and that their prayers were creating a spiritual energy that was bringing about a new climate for peace. John Paul II allowed his good friend the Dalai Lama to put the Buddha on the altar in St. Peter's Church in Assisi, and with his monks to have a Buddhist worship ceremony there while Shintoists chanted and rang their bells outside. The prophesied world religion is in the process of being formed before...
shows up and says, James, you better get back home and finish your chores before your dad shows up.
What a crazy world we live in. I mean, at my last job at customer service, customers were always trying to lie and steal things. And anytime one of us would get onto them, they would play the gender card or the race card or the religion card.
Or the age card. I mean, it seems like there's a card for everything these days.
You got that right. I mean, you can't have an intelligent conversation with anyone these days because somebody's going to get offended.
Hey, Brother Holmes.
Hey.
How you doing?
Hey, Tom. How was church last Sunday?
That's right. You were away. What's it called?
Drill. It was my weekend.
That's right, Brother. Church was good. The preacher talked about faith during the end times. You know, when Jesus returns, it'll be in the twinkling of an eye. It'll be like that. It's real fast. And there won't be any warning. And then the preacher asked us, what will you be doing the moment Jesus returns for his people? Man, that's deep. I sure hope I'm on my best behavior.
It's an interesting thought. God is good, you know. I think as long as we're born again Christians, it doesn't really matter.
Well, it's good seeing you, Brother Holmes.
I guess
have a good day.
Yeah. Same. 1, 2, 3.
Top secret meeting coming up in a few days.
Really?
Yeah, they won't tell me anything about it except it may mean a promotion.
I thought we agreed you were getting out of the reserves. You know how crazy things are getting with the government?
You know, I know, sweetheart. I'm a little nervous about this meeting myself. They won't even tell us where we're supposed to be at until an hour before we're supposed to meet. And something else that's weird about this is I think I'm the only person in my whole unit who was even invited.
Really, Chris? This could be a bad thing. Is there any way you can get out of it?
No, it's mandatory. Listen, sweetheart. I know you don't like to hear this, but God is in control. You know, he will take care of us.
I can't believe you still believe in God. Have you not seen the world lately? All these innocent people are dying left and right.
The world has become a playground for sin. I mean, what do you expect to happen in a world that's so full of sin?
Well, if your God is so powerful, why doesn't he destroy the devil and make things good again?
Because God is good. You know, he tells us, thou shalt not kill, and he doesn't break his own commandments.
Well, you think he would make an exception in this case?
You must understand that God created man with a free will. It wasn't God who turned his back on man. It was man who turned his back on God. I mean, it wasn't God who brought pain and destruction to this world. It was the devil. And one day God will return and the devil will be tried just like in a court of law. And all the people who follow the devil will be punished right along with him.
Well, I think if God was going to come back, he would already done it, so... I love you, babe, but all I ask, and I respect your beliefs, is that you respect mine. I'm going to put the kids to bed.
Hey, buddy. What are you doing still awake?
Mm-hmm.
Is everything okay?
I'm afraid something's gonna get me.
Oh, okay. Nothing's gonna get you, Zeke. Mommy and Daddy are here. Do you remember when I taught you how to pray?
But Mommy says praying doesn't work.
Well, Mommy is, Mommy's a little confused right now. You see, I know that praying works because I've seen it firsthand.
You have?
I sure have. When I was away at war, God protected me. I wouldn't be here right now if it wasn't for God.
I'm glad God protected you.
I am too, son. Love you.
Love you too.
All right, buddy. You go to sleep. Have sweet dreams.
You too.
So, Granny?
What's wrong, honey?
Not really used to bodyguards.
Sir, times are changing.
Yeah. Okay, listen up, people. I have a lot of information that I need to convey to you, but I have just a short time to do so. So you need to listen very closely. And hear me, and hear me good. You're probably wondering why we're meeting out here in the woods in a little Baptist church. Well, you've all received more than top secret clearance, so I can speak freely to you of many of these things. We have infiltrated many such churches throughout the nation because we are about to usher in a new dawning in history. In this Aquarian age, we are about to unfold the New World Order. Now, what you need to understand is that you all have been chosen because you are the best of the armed forces of the United States of America, which is the best of the world. You all have had your special forces training, and you all have your fields of expertise, but there are things that you share in common. We have been watching you from the cradle, even until now. You were marked as children, as indigo children. You were children that we knew that we were shaping for the leadership of this world to come. But you see, each of you have sworn allegiance to the Constitution of the United States of America. Now, we find all this to be very admirable, and it shows that you're trustworthy. But there is something greater than the Constitution of the United States of America, and it is the Constitution of the New World Order. And so what we are requiring of you today is that each of you swear your allegiance, your ultimate allegiance, to the Constitution of the New World Order. And also you need to realize that when you do so, that you are swearing allegiance to the man who is at this time still in the shadows, but he is known in our circles as the new Messiah, as the new Christ. Now, if there's any of you who are squeamish about anything that I'm about to say, you need to let me know this because you will be dismissed from this program promptly.
Sir, my name is Captain Christopher Holmes, U.S. Army Reserves. I'm also a reporter for the Sun and Stripes News.
Yes, Captain Holmes, I am very familiar with your work. What is your question?
Sir, with all due respect, I disagree with a lot of things you are saying. Number one, I am a Christian. I'm an American. I stand up for the U.S. Constitution. And if you had truly been following me since birth, then you would know that I am not in favor of this one world order, even though it is obviously happening. Number two, it seems to me that you are tampering with powers that are not meant for human beings. Sure, it's possible for humans to do supernatural things if God empowers us to do so. But what you are trying to do is you're trying to play God. I mean, the Bible says that we would do greater things than even He. But what you're doing is you're using trickery and satanic influence to try to fool people into believing this garbage.
Yes, Mr. Holmes, you are entitled to your opinion, but I'm not going to banter back and forth with you about this. You have made yourself unwilling to be a part of our new world order. You have counted yourself not worthy to be one of our grand number. So therefore, you are dismissed, and you will receive an honorable discharge from the United States Armed Forces. Albeit, I need to warn you that if you ever utter any of this our business, it would be better for you had you never been born.
Well, sir, I want you to know that I'll be praying for you. If you men still honored your oath to defend the Constitution, you can get up and walk out.
We have another defector, Father. Christopher Holmes, Captain Christopher Holmes. Now, people, all of you have decided that you want to be a part of this. We have not coerced you into it. This is all of your own volition. Now, therefore, you need to listen to me like you've never listened before. We are going to develop your special powers. We are going to develop your power to levitate your own body, the bodies of others, and objects and things throughout a room. But that's just the beginning. We will initiate you into the secrets of the occult and the latest developments in the realms of Satanism. You see, because you have decided to stay, you're going to be a part of the new Christ, who the Bible calls the Antichrist, the new Messiah. He will be the Savior of the world, because you see, very soon, Jesus Christ of the Bible is going to return for His followers, and He is going to take them up in what is commonly known as the rapture. But do not be afraid of any of this, because greater is He that is in the world than He that is in the heavens. And we will conquer, and we will be the victors, and we will usher in this grand and glorious age of Aquarius. Well, now that the room has been cleared of these unbelievers, I will demonstrate to you some of the powers of the mind that we have mastered at the Institute, and powers which I incidentally would like to say you will be doing as well. Now I will demonstrate for you the power of levitation.
Whoa. How do we know this isn't some kind of trick?
Perhaps this will end your skepticism.
Oh! Someone get me down from here! Now! Brother Elijah! Stop this madness!
Now do you continue to doubt? Now let's move on. There is much to discuss.
Their final goal, they have goals just like anybody has goals. And they have the final goal to take over this whole world and control the whole world and everybody in it and have them in slavery underneath them. Wherever the Catholics have gone, the first thing they do is get the cities in debt. The next thing is to get the county in debt. The next thing is to get the state in debt. The next thing is to get the government in debt. That's how they got control of Great Britain. That's how they got control of the United States. And when they get control of one of the state, got control of the United States, now they're trying to get control of every country in the whole world. And they've got the world underneath a bind at the present time to where the economy is, where it works to a condition to where they take over. And they're working for a one-world government, a one-world takeover, and it's coming fast, faster than most people think.
I demand to know how this happened. How did this infidel get into our meeting?
Father, Captain Holmes was logged into our system as being an atheist.
Who logged that report?
He says identity unknown. This has never happened before, Father.
We have never dealt with a situation like this before. Defectors in the past have at least been believers in the One World Order. Cowards, but believers nonetheless. Holmes will present a problem. He must be eliminated.
And what about Steinbeck?
Who does the Steinbeck think he is? Terminating the defector's military career aloud so that all may hear. He does not have the authority to do so, especially in front of new initiates.
But his demands must be carried out, or else the witnesses will view him as incapable.
Things are getting out of control.
Honey, I can't believe it. I'm sitting there and the guy tells me I'm out of the military. And then, not even a minute later, my commander gives me a call. And my mind is just blown right now. I don't even know what to think. Honey, just wait a minute. Let me give you a call back.
Enough of these formalities.
Yes, Father. Father, the defector has been taken care of.
Very well.
May I suggest, sir, corrective actions be taken against Father Steinbeck?
Steinbeck has become a loose cannon. We need to show him how powerless he really is.
I think I have an idea.
You're not thinking. Good, good.
Consider it done.
Honey, I have to go. It's business. I have no choice. Listen, don't make this any harder than it has to be. This is something that I have to do. You know that I have this life that I have to live, and there's things that I'm doing that are going to be monumental.
Elijah, the more of these trips you take, it seems the further you get away from the true path, as well as from me.
Lynn, you talk like I'm some kind of a heathen or something. What's with that?
Elijah, I'm not trying to make you angry. I'm just very much afraid that something bad is about to happen.
Lynn, believe me. Just believe me. Trust in me. That I've got everything under control. It's going to be all right. But I've got to do this. I've got to go. Just have faith in me. And when we get back, we'll go on a vacation up to the mountains somewhere. How does that sound?
Okay, Elijah. That sounds wonderful. Oh, no. I've lost track of the time. I've got to meet Granny B for lunch.
Okay. Well, listen. Don't worry, babe. I'll be back soon. Before you know it, it'll be a short trip.
Okay, well, I better get going. Have a good trip. I love you.
everything looks good. I'm gonna go get your discharge paper and I'll be right back.
Okay, thank you.
You're welcome.
Well, we now think it was Elijah Steinbeck that's been trying to kill you. CSI matched up paint chips found at the scene to his car, and the slugs recovered also matched the .38 Smith & Wesson, same kind that's registered to him.
That's what I suspected.
Also, Steinbeck's wife didn't die from natural causes, as everybody's reporting it to be. Chris, she died in an explosion.
An explosion?
I overheard some of the boys talking about it down at the station. She blew up in her driveway. What kind of maniac would want to do that to his wife?
But more importantly, what is a Jesuit priest doing with a wife?
Jesuit priest? I thought he was an old Baptist preacher.
Yeah, the Jesuits have been sending in fake preachers to teach false doctrines in the churches.
Are you serious?
I've been doing a lot of thinking since that top secret meeting. You know, it doesn't take a rocket scientist to figure out that a lot of churches nowadays are nothing but a club. You know, preachers are teaching people what they want to hear and not what the Bible actually says. They're afraid of stepping on somebody's toes. It doesn't surprise me that the Jesuits are capitalizing on this. I just find it all so bizarre.
What in the world is Steinbeck up to?
Who knows?
No, thank you, Chief. My goodness, traffic was so bad. Are you okay, honey? I'm so sorry it took so long to get here.
It's okay, honey. They had to dig a bullet out of my leg and doctor up some scrapes and bruises, but I'll be okay.
How was someone trying to kill you?
That's what we're trying to find out.
Listen, Lydia, the department's going to have to put you and your family under 24-hour surveillance until all this is said and done. We can't be too safe now.
Oh my goodness, I can't believe this is happening. And besides that, you lost your job in the reserves, and we needed that money.
I know, darling, but, you know, we have to rely on God to take care of us.
Unbelievable.
Skip a rock. Think, man, think. I'm gonna get revenge. Somehow, I'm gonna get revenge.
morning, buddy.
You feeling better?
I'm doing a lot better. I'm just trying to stay off my leg.
Oh, well, that's good. How come you and Mommy argue so much?
Well, sometimes parents don't see eye to eye on things. It doesn't mean that we don't love each other. It just means that, you know, we're trying to sort things out.
Okay. Will Mommy go to heaven?
Let's just keep praying for Mommy, okay?
Okay. See ya. I'm going to go play with
Liam. Alrighty. See you later. Who entereth herein, a conqueror hath been. Who slayeth the dragon, the shield he shall win.
Oh, Pastor Stanley. Hey, won't you please come in? It's so good to see you. Come on in. Be careful. Have a seat, Pastor. Would you like something to drink?
Yeah, maybe some tea.
Hot tea?
Yeah, hot tea's good. Thanks.
Okay. Mm-hmm. I've been worried sick about you. Yeah. Here, be careful now, that's hot. Don't spill it on you.
Thank you very much.
And I heard about the passing of your wife. I am so sorry.
Well, actually, Granny B, there's something I wanted to talk to you about her passing. It's not at all what it seems to be.
Pastor, I'm so sorry to hear about that. What happened?
She didn't just die, but she was murdered. They blew her up in a car. It's worse. I don't know how to explain this to you, but you know, all these years that I've been the pastor of this Baptist church, I'm not really a Baptist preacher.
Pastor, Lord have mercy, that is awful. But you know, I have a confession to make too. I kind of suspected all along that you weren't a Baptist preacher.
Really? But how did you know?
You know how close Lynn and I were. She did tell me that she saw your rosary beads and you praying to Mary.
But why did y'all let this continue? I mean, why didn't you stop it?
Pastor, we've been trusting in the Lord and praying for you, and we believe that He is going to save you.
Granny, I've got to tell you that I don't know how to take all this. The fact is, not only am I not really a Baptist preacher, but I've been a Jesuit priest for all these years. And having been your pretend pastor all of this time, I don't know what's happened to me, but I'm starting to believe some of this Bible. I'm starting to believe some of the things that I've been saying, that you've all been saying. And I'm starting to fully believe, I'm convinced that these people who I've been laboring my whole life to help, that they're evil. I thought that they were the true church, but I see now that it's just evil and I've just been a pawn in their hands. And all I can feel now that they've taken my wife away from me, I just feel like having revenge. Just like I just want to strangle somebody. But at the same time, I hear this voice in my head saying, no, vengeance is mine. It was one of those Bible verses that we've been quoting all this time. And vengeance is mine, saith the Lord, I will repay. And I'm just starting to believe that God wants something different for me. And I just don't quite know how to get there.
Pastor Steinbeck, do you care if I pray for you right now?
I wish you would.
Okay. Oh, our most precious Lord, we just come to you, bringing you before you, Brother Steinbeck. We just pray that you will help him and help his heart, Lord. We know how much he's hurting, and help him to cope with the death of his wife. We pray that you'll help him, and that may we help him to learn that Jesus Christ is our Savior. Amen.
Lord, I don't understand any of this. I don't even know who I'm praying to, but at this point I don't know what to do. But I'm just asking you to show me the truth and show me how I can find what I need to find, but I just have so much confusion. Lord, please help me. Granny B, I gotta tell you something. They're gonna come after me. You know, I'm a Jesuit priest, and they're never gonna let me go. I'm gonna have to go underground. I'm gonna have to go. But I need contacts, people who can help me and be my ears and be my eyes to see what's going on. And I'm just asking you, would you help me with this?
Well, nobody's heard or seen anything from old Steinbeck since his wife was blown up in a car.
What does that mean exactly?
Well, running away from two separate crime scenes don't exactly make you look innocent, you know what I mean?
Oh yeah.
Brother, just who are these Jesuits you keep jabbering about?
Well, I've been doing some research. Evidently, they were founded back in the 1500s by a French man named Ignatius. He claimed that he had, you know, these visions from God.
No kidding.
Yeah, they were the original secret society, as well as the world's most dangerous cult.
So like old Jim Jones, huh?
Yeah, it's all through their history. I mean, they were involved with both world wars, the Holocaust. They founded organizations like the Ku Klux Klan, the Illuminati. They were even behind the Lincoln assassination.
You've been listening to that talk radio again, Kimo Sabe? Sounds a little like conspiracy theory to me.
Well now, this stuff has been proven over and over again throughout history. It was very well documented by their own writers, nonetheless. I think it's considered fact, not theory. Their main goal is to infiltrate churches, politics, to try to bring about their new world order, which I believe is controlled by the Antichrist.
The Antichrist? The very thought of that scares the devil out of me. No pun intended.
Specialized work in dealing with the infiltration of churches and religious institutions as well as government. That cover a tremendous number of institutions.
And the purpose of that infiltration was what for?
Well, the purpose is what the Roman Catholic system has all the time as her own purpose, is to infiltrate, to penetrate all the areas of life where the Roman Catholic can have control and access for the coming world government.
He is the first Jesuit Pope. He is the Pope that, of a group of people, he is a representative of a group of people that everybody has feared, these Jesuits. They are the most effective intelligence organization in the world. Even the CIA says that.
We need to remember that we are followers of Jesus Christ, and his life, humanly speaking, ended in failure, the failure of the cross.
Hey, brother, you up?
Oh, hey, brother, come on in.
Well, it's nice to see you up and about, brother.
Nothing I hate more than being stuck inside the house. What brings you out this way?
I'll just check up on you and give you an update on old Steinbeck.
Yeah, I've seen the news, man. The man's making quite a name for himself. They said he stole some kind of top secret documents from Fort Blanding.
Yeah, but that's not the weird part. Listen, can I tell you something as a friend and knowledge reporter?
Of course.
What I have to say can't leave these here walls. If it does, I could lose my job over this.
I understand. I won't tell anyone. Hey, have a seat. Let's talk about it.
I was one of the officers on the scene when Steinbeck tried to escape. And what I seen him do, it was unbelievable.
What did you see?
At first I thought I was hallucinating or dreaming or something. But the more I realize now and think about it, what I saw was real. I saw him disappear.
You saw him do what?
Literally, right before my eyes. One second he's there, next second he's gone. Like an invisible man or something.
You know, the Bible tells us that these things are going to happen. The Bible calls them lying signs and wonders. I'm beginning to wonder if Mr. Steinbeck isn't dealing with witchcraft. You know, there's no telling what all he'll do with that information he stole.
Sounds like a good news story to me, brother.
God knows I need the money. I wonder how hard it would be to find him.
Every law enforcement agency in the country is looking for him. FBI, CIA, OSI, NSA. I don't think you stand half a chance, brother. And let's not forget, somebody wants you dead, my friend.
I know, but I just have this feeling, you know, something here just doesn't add up. How on earth did a born-again, confessed Christian end up at that meeting? I mean, there's no way the Jesuits would have invited me to that meeting. You know, I just can't help but feel that I was brought into all of this for a reason. What if God has a plan for me?
Well, it's definitely a possibility, brother.
What if God is the one who's putting this burning desire in my heart to reach out to Steinbeck?
And then what?
I guess we'll, figure that out when the time comes.
Thank you.
I really wish you wouldn't do this.
You know we've been over this.
I never agreed to it.
I really feel like this is something God wants us to do.
You know, you'll never find me.
Maybe so, but I had to try.
Just be careful. I love you. Hurry back.
I love you too. I'll be careful.
Man, that was miserable. Oh, I can't do it like this tonight. Sleeping bag's all wet with dew. Oh, man. I've got to find a better spot than this. You're fit to drink. There ain't no spring chicken. So this is the famous New River. Huh. Ain't that something? Hey, little guy, what you doing? What are you doing out here, huh? Oh, you're a fast little fella. Huh, I wonder if he can climb. People are just totally disgusting, throwing garbage out even in the woods. You can't go anywhere to get away from it. It's a disgrace.
Go out in the middle of nowhere without any radio, without any cell phone, without any electronics whatsoever?
I don't want to give the government a chance to track me if I do find Steinbeck. I want to have a moment to talk with him first.
Look, man, you're really putting me in a hard situation here. I mean, we're trying to apprehend this guy, not go out there and have tea and cookies with him. I mean, he tried to kill you for Pete's sake, man. What if he tries that again?
I'm not really worried about that. I'll have my gun with me, plus I'll keep my wits about me. I've been in worse situations than Steinbeck could ever put me in.
I hope you're right. Just know that I wish you'd reconsider all this.
Don't worry, my friend. I appreciate you taking me to the drop-off spot. Remember, don't tell anyone.
Yeah, I know. Need to tell the boys down at the apartment to fix these potholes. Judas Priest. What makes you think he's even gonna be out here?
I was reading some of Steinbeck's old documents, and he refers a lot to the New River. And I figured this would be a good place to start.
Well, take care of Lydia and the kids for me while I'm gone. Pray for me.
I'll be praying for you, all right.
Yes, perfect. The saints be praised. This is a perfect hideout.
The suspect Steinbeck was last seen at this location under Camp Blanding, and I think it would be good to expedite crews out of Keystone coming up 21, and we'll send search parties from there as well as from 230 where it ties into 16 going north of Kingsley Lake. We should get these crews out within the next 12 hours.
How this got out here.
How did you do that?
There's a lot about me you don't know.
Well, hurry up and cut me down.
Anyway, I knew I'd find you.
Looks to me like I found you. This was meant for deer, but I guess a hostage will have to do.
Hostage?
Yeah, just in case my enemies think they're a little bit wittier than I.
Do you honestly think they would try to spare my life? It was your men that tried to have me killed.
My men? I don't even know what you're talking about. And besides, there's more than just my men that are after me. Why were you looking for me anyway?
Well, to be honest with you, I feel like God wants me to talk to you.
God, it wouldn't happen to really have something to do with you being a news reporter now, would it?
I've learned more about the world these last few weeks than I ever have. I believe the military was going to get rid of me anyway. They were just waiting for the right excuse. And as far as me being a reporter, yeah, I want to know exactly why they're after you.
That's enough. Be quiet. I need you to keep silent and come with me.
As a hostage?
Yeah, I can't risk you going back and telling them where I'm at now, can I?
As long as we can talk.
We'll talk when I say we'll talk. For now, get going. Keep quiet.
Lord, please help me.
Go left. Left.
Something just don't feel right here.
What?
It's just a feeling I have, a feeling of darkness and evil.
Don't worry about your feelings right now. Just get moving.
I'm telling you, it's the same feeling I had when I was in your meeting.
What? Listen, I'm tired of this. I want you to go, and go now.
So where are you taking me anyway?
Just keep going. It's just a few more steps.
From what? I don't see anything.
From what? From my secret fortress.
You call this a fortress? Well, how do you know they won't just come and find you here?
Because I am invisible to their sight. I can be seen or not seen at my own will.
You're under a delusion. You know, the Antichrist will pull the same junk in the end days.
What are you talking about?
I just don't want any part of your witchcraft.
You're going to do as I say. Get going.
I'm going to stay right here.
I said get going. Wait a minute. To help your unbelief, observe. Now keep going. Let's go. Wait, hold up. Now, what do you think about that?
What the Bible calls a lying sign and wonder.
You know what, smart guy? You've got the answer for everything, don't you? Well, let me ask you a question here. Let me ask you, why hasn't your Jesus given you the power that my masters have given me?
Because the Bible says that the only sign we as Christians need is that Jesus rose from the dead.
Yeah, I've heard all the Bible stories.
You know, that's a good way to give away your position.
I told you already that we are invisible to them. And furthermore, they can't hear the sound of the gun. Now get moving. For the last time, go! I said, go!
According to the Associated Press, the now former Israeli President Shimon Peres has proposed a new global peace initiative to Pope Francis. A United Nations Humanist Association found that one-third would like the words "under God" removed.
They have their fingers in everything. And so when I saw the Jesuit Pope get elected, get appointed, I just thought, wow, this is incredible. I mean, it is appropriate because we live in the last days. So, I mean, we're very close to the end.
Lie, and here comes the Jesuit.
It's a little hard to figure out what the truth is. So we have to ultimately rely on the Bible. So as we look at all these things, we just realize, wait a second, what all these people are doing is just pushing us towards whatever the Bible said is going to happen.
Don't you think it's a little odd that they blew up your wife like that?
Yeah, listen, I find that very odd. and that disturbs me every moment of my day. I can't hardly stand the thought of it. But I want you
to... How do you know that these things that you're believing in and trusting in are even real?
Listen, as though it were any of your business, let me inform you that I have spirit guides, and they've taught me magic. I mean, this dome that I have over this place, this place is invisible to those people that are trying to find me. And not only that, I've been assured by my good friend, Padre Pio, that he will certainly keep me from spending any more than a week in purgatory. He's gotten that information from Our Lady of Fatima, so I know it's real.
How do you know that this Lady of Fatima and this Padre Pio, or Pio, whatever his name is, how do you know that they're not duking you like the rest?
Shut up! I've had enough of you! I'm not going to sit here and allow you to blaspheme the Virgin Mary and the saints of God! You dirty heretic, I've got a good mind just to raise you up and throw you to the ground!
Listen, I'm not trying to, you know, make you mad, or I'm not even trying to argue with you. It's just Catholicism, Buddhism, Hinduism, Shamanism, Protestantism. How do you bring all these things together and reconcile them under one religion?
Can't you see that we are on the brink of bringing the world to peace? Peace, just like in the Garden of Eden. We're trying to make a world that all of us are gathered together as brothers, and all of these religions can practice their religion because we all can join in with them, and it'll all be under the authority of the Pope.
Well, listen, don't you believe that the Bible is God's word and it's something to be taken seriously?
Yeah, I believe in the Bible. I believe it's God's word, but I believe that we, the church, the leaders of the church, that we are the sole interpreters of the Bible. People like you can't understand what the message of the Bible is. We have to interpret it for you. And furthermore, we have the traditions, the dogmas of the church, the canons and the bulls that the popes have set forth. And these popes are the successors of the Peter, the apostle. And so... I believe the Bible is God's word, but I also believe that all the decrees of the church are God's word.
Well, what about your wife? I mean, she's a Bible believer. She was a born-again Christian.
I want you to shut up! You've said enough about my wife, all right? I don't want to hear no more about it. She was a Bible Christian, yes, she was. And she was one of the greatest people I've ever known. But you don't know nothing about this.
Professor Steinbeck, I'm just trying to get you to understand that the Bible is God's word. Though Jesus Christ says that no man may come to the Father except by me.
I'm thinking about all this. You've got my ear, but you gotta give me some room. I've gotta have time to think about this, to digest it. I mean, my whole life has just been a sham.
That's fair enough.
Why did you hit me in the chin with that frying pan?
You're lucky I didn't use my machete. That's what I do to people that sneak around my house. Do you know what you need? You need the Lord.
You know, Elijah, I understand your reasoning for picking a hideout that's so high, but
I don't know if we can tolerate much more of this heat.
You know what, Holmes? You're just a big crybaby. You whine about everything. Oh, yeah, the sun's shining, the sun's shining. And then later on this evening, you'll be saying, oh, I'm so it's cold. You know, you're the most whiny hostage I've ever taken.
I don't get you. I'm beginning to wonder if you're even human.
Yeah, I'm human, all right. But let me tell you something, Holmes. I'm smarter than you.
Yeah, yeah. That's what you want to believe.
Well, what a crybaby you are. Wait, hold up, Holmes. Listen, if you'll give me your word, as an officer and a gentleman, that you won't try to run away or try anything funny, I'll put the gun away.
Okay, I'll give you my word.
All right.
I appreciate that. Listen, Elijah, you know, sooner or later you're going to run out of food and water. And the people who are looking for you will be on top of you like a flea on top of a dog.
Holmes, you don't get it, do you? You just don't get it.
No, I really don't get it.
You don't get it. I'm invisible to them. They can't see me. I can walk amongst them, and they'll never know that I'm there. Now do you get it?
What are you going to do when your powers run out?
My powers aren't going to run out, fella.
Yeah, sure, if that's what you want to tell yourself.
Wait, what do you mean by that?
Look at yourself, man. I mean, you're straddling the fence. I mean, you don't know what or who you even believe in. I mean, you know, you spent so long pretending to be a Christian that you're beginning to doubt your own faith.
You know what? Yeah, I have doubts. I have doubts every day. I have regrets. My conscience hurts me. I've seen all the evil deeds that the Jesuits have done, and you know what? I've participated in many of those deeds, but I want to know one thing. What does that have to do with my powers?
Because the farther away you get from your anti-Christian beliefs, the weaker your witchcraft will become.
You're wrong. My powers will never become weak. I will always be strong because the saints are praying for me.
But you must become weak in the flesh in order to be strong in the spirit.
You know what? You're starting to sound just like my wife. And you know what? She was wrong about that. And you're wrong. I'll never be weak. What? You listen to me. I will never be weak. I'll always be strong. Where are you going?
Gotta get out of this heat.
Don't you understand what I'm trying to say, Holmes? Nobody understands what I'm trying to say. Oh, it's so hot. Miserable.
Elijah, if your wife is wrong, then you have absolutely no chance of ever seeing her again.
I don't understand, Holmes.
Your wife was a born-again Christian. She believed that the Bible was, and only the Bible, was God's word. You see, the Bible teaches that as born-again Christians, when we die, we are taken up into heaven to live eternally with Him.
Jesuits believe in the heaven, Holmes. We're not ignorant about that.
But not the right heaven. You see, the Bible teaches that the only way into heaven is by accepting Jesus Christ as our Lord and Savior. Catholicism, on the other hand, teaches that the only way into the gates is through worshiping the Virgin Mary and by accomplishing all these different tasks. They're both saying two completely different things. Only one of them can be right.
I'll give you that. I never really thought about any of it that way. I don't know.
And another thing, I mean, just think about this. You know, you say that your wife and this other person, I think you called her Granny, you know, you say that they're saints. You know, they believed in Jesus Christ as their Lord and Savior, just like I do. But you call them saints and you call me a heretic. I mean, just think about that. How does that make sense?
One night he told you that they run our church. Tell us about that.
His people run our church, he said.
Who were his people?
The Catholic Church. The Catholic Church run all churches.
He said that to you?
Yes, yes.
Jesuits under the stream of an induction, they were not directly to be involved. They only were the elements, the intellectual element that will prepare this. The case of Abraham Lincoln. Abraham Lincoln, the president, was killed by the Jesuits of Rome, but there was no a Jesuit there involved directly. Nevertheless, was the Jesuit who prepared the plot against his life and prepared and trained those who were to kill him.
They arranged it.
Yes. Yeah. It happened with President Kennedy, the same thing.
You know something, Holmes? There's something different about you. I can't quite put my finger on it, but I don't know, something special. Maybe it's because you seem to have a whole different, a higher order of what's right and what's wrong, and a code of honor or something. I can't figure you out.
Elijah, if you see anything special in me, it's Jesus Christ shining through.
I don't understand all that.
Brother, I've been praying for you.
What for, Holmes? I mean, why are you praying for me? I've always thought that I was as good as the next guy and actually better than most. But you know, something strange has happened these past few days. I've come to see myself as evil, as very evil. I believe that I've maybe committed some unpardonable sin that I can never be forgiven.
You know, everybody makes mistakes. The Bible says that Jesus died for the ungodly man. That feeling that you're feeling is probably just the Lord trying to let you know that your ways are sinful. That witchcraft is wrong. And, you know, where there is breath, there is hope.
You know, listen, I've been religious my whole life. I'm very religious, but I just feel like I'm doomed.
Religion is about the things that you do, but faith is about your personal, true relationship with God through Jesus Christ, His Son.
Listen, Christopher, I'm going to level with you. I have talked to the saints of God that have died, and I've talked to their spirits, and also I have many spirit guides that I have been talking with.
Well, to be honest with you, you weren't really speaking with the saints. You were talking with demons just trying to masquerade as saints.
You know what? Just a couple of days ago, I would have killed you for making those remarks. But now I'm becoming more and more convinced that you're speaking the truth. But how can I be freed from all of this? All this manifested evil all around me and in me. How can I be free?
By the miracle of the second birth, Jesus says that you must be born again.
Yes, Holmes, I've read very much about reincarnation. I know about all that.
I'm not talking about reincarnation. You know, Jesus says that, you know, in order for a man to be born again, he must come before the Lord with repentance. He must, by faith, ask Jesus to come into his heart.
What do you mean, this faith? I'm already a positive thinker. In fact, I practice mind over matter all the time in my magic.
Elijah, you know, you have to get away from all this magic stuff. Listen, the only way to receive salvation
is through the cleansing blood of Jesus Christ.
How can I have this faith? I still don't understand. How can I have this saving faith that you're talking about?
You simply hear the word of God. As Christ draws you close to him, by faith you simply accept him into your heart.
Are you telling me that if I believe that Jesus can save me, then he'll save me?
It's not just a matter of believing that he can save you, but you have to know that he will save you. You cannot save yourself. Only the blood of Christ can set you free.
But I feel so inadequate.
That's because you are. You know, listen, God wants to make you a new man. He wants to give you a new Christ-like nature.
You know, I hear you, and I find myself actually believing what you're saying.
Just hold on a minute, Elijah. This is the Holy Bible. I want to encourage you to read the book of John. It's very eye-opening.
Thanks, Christopher.
Holmes? It looks like they're getting closer, and my powers are becoming weak.
Well, you know, that's a good thing. You need to let Christ fight your battles now.
Come take a look at this. Our sensors are picking up a new heat signature that was not there before.
Okay, Steinbeck. We got you now.
Right at the verge of being able to deliver the product.
You know, an integral part of the papal policy was an organization called the Inquisition during the Middle Ages. It began in the 12th century under Innocent III, which was the most powerful of all the popes of that time period. The purpose of the Inquisition was to seek out heresy and stop it, but it used some very unorthodox methods. One of those methods was to force certain confessions out of Christians or others, and with those confessions, use them to form public opinion, to raise crusades, to destroy the primitive Christian church. Crusades went out that destroyed people by the millions. We'll not know how many until the judgment day. But the Inquisition, the Catholic Church said, well, yes, there was an Inquisition, yes, we destroyed people, but it was part of the barbarity of the times. Others did it too. But of course, she claims that she's changed today, and Protestants are believing her. But you know, the Inquisition still exists, and it's actively being carried out. Beneath many of her large churches today are instruments of torture.
Still in control. The Catholics are going to do what they're going to do. And there's nothing we can do about it, only just go out and do what we can to warn other people and get them into the right channel.
Does the idea of assassination, murder, persecution and suffering bother you? It really shouldn't. I remember when a Roman Catholic priest stood in this studio and told me that they were watching me and that they were serious about any threat to what they wanted to do. I told him, go ahead, shoot. What difference does it make? As long as I'm alive, I'll present this truth, but if I die, then my troubles are over. Everyone that will be in heaven will have suffered for Christ. When we get there, our Master will have scars in his hands. And only if we suffer will we feel we have a perfect right to that place. In fact, in Revelation 12, verse 11, we read, and they overcame him by the blood of the Lamb, by the word of their testimony, and they loved not their lives unto death. This message we have to give, we've got to give without worrying about consequences. It's a divine message of truth. It can't fail. We're fulfilling the prophecies of the closing events, and it's going to go through to completion.
You see, there is part of the oath and induction that I was taking as I swear to take the life not only of kings and princes and governors and mayors and senators and congressmen, but even my mother or father or brother or sister, whosoever, come to be between the interests of the Roman Catholic system and the interests that they pursued. What that means is, if a president of a nation is there to interfere with the interests of the Roman Catholic institution and their pursuit of power, they will be crushed. I was granted that authority, that power, to exercise that authority, that power. That when any individual, whether it is a child, whether it is whether it is a woman, whether it is an elder man, whether it is a boy, whether it is a girl, whether it is a king or a queen, regardless of who the person is, when that person, that city, that nation, this country opposed to the goals of the Roman Catholic Institute and interfere with that already call for disaster.